हेलो हेलो मैम, हेलो मैम, इज इट ओके नाउ? हेलो
हाँ सर, हाँ
हाँ
इट्स
सर,
विजिबल, हाँ इट्स
हाँ ओके
विजिबल।
ओके सॉरी गाइस, ड्यू टू सम लैपटॉप प्रॉब्लम आई शट डाउन। ओके लेट अस सी दिस प्रॉब्लम।
कंटिन्यू सर, कंटिन्यू सर।
हाँ ओके ओके मैम। ओके लेट्स सी द प्रॉब्लम। ए सिंगल फेस लाइन हैज़ टू पैरेलल कंडक्टर्स विच आर 2 मीटर्स अपार्ट एंड द डायमीटर ऑफ ईच कंडक्टर इज 1.2 सेंटीमीटर्स एंड कैलकुलेट द लूप इंडक्टेंस पर किलोमीटर ऑफ द लाइन। ओके राइट, हियर ए सिंगल फेज लाइन इज गिवन विच आर हैविंग टू कंडक्टर्स सो विच आर 2 मीटर्स अपार्ट, सो द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू कंडक्टर्स इज 2 मीटर्स एंड डायामीटर ऑफ ईच कंडक्टर, सो डायामीटर डी ऑफ ईच कंडक्टर इज गिवन एज 1.2 सेंटीमीटर्स। ओके सो डायामीटर इज 1.2, सो देन रेडियस इज सो हाफ ऑफ दिस वैल्यू जे दैट इज 0.6 सेंटीमीटर्स। राइट, 0.6 सेंटीमीटर इज द रेडियस ऑफ ईच कंडक्टर, सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द लूप इंडक्टेंस। सो लूप इंडक्टेंस फॉर ए सिंगल फेज ट्रांसमिशन लाइन इज 4 × 10⁻⁷ ln d by r dash here. So r dash here, in r dash is nothing but 0.7788 times 88 times the actual radius. Okay, so now you know the radius of the conductor, which is 0.6 centimeters. So then if you substitute this value in this equation, you will get the r dash, right? And the distance between the conductors is capital D, which is equal to 2 meters. Okay, so distance is given in meters and radius is given in centimeter, right? So now here, while substituting the values in this expression d by r dash, so you take the same units, right? When d is in meters, so r should be also in meters. You convert r to meters, or you convert d to centimeters. So 2 meters is nothing but how many centimeters? So 200, right? So 200 by 0.6 you substitute here, right? If you substitute all the parameters in this expression, so you will get the inductance of the this system, so which is 2.423, so millihenries. Okay, so millihenries per kilometer. So they were asked me in the question as inductance per kilometer they were asked, right? So now when you use the first formula, you will get the value in henries per meter. Okay, so after getting the value in henries per meter, you have to convert into per kilometer. Okay, so simply you have to multiply with 1000. So per meter value, this value, so for 1 kilometer you have to multiply that with 1000. So else if you want, if you use the second equation, you will directly get the this value in kilometers per kilometer only. The inductance you will get. Okay, so you can use any formula, right? So final inductance value is 2.423 milli henries. Okay, right. What is a standard conductor? Let us recall about the standard. So while explaining types of conductors, I said that in transmission lines you generally use the stranded conductors, not the solid conductors. Solid conductors are not preferred for transmission lines. So stranded conductors will be used for transmission system. So a standard conductors will be looking like this picture, looking like this. So which is shown in here. Right, if you see this picture, so it is having some conductor like in some layers. So first layer is having one conductor and second layer is having 6 conductor and third layer is having how many conductors, sir? 2 2 2 6 8 10, almost 10 conductors are there here, right? So on outer conductor maybe 19 I think so. Okay, so we will not use the solid conductors in transmission system. We will use the stranded conductors, which will be looking like this, right? So these each strand will also be twisted in opposite directions in between two layers. So suppose if you take the adjacent two layers, right, one layer conductors are spiral in one direction and other layer will be spiraled in opposite direction, okay, so that the spiraling will increases the mechanical strength to the conductors. So now if you want to determine how many number of strands will be there in a single single stranded conductor, so you have the one empirical formula, which is n is equal to 3x square minus 3x plus 1, right? So by using this formula, you can determine the total number of strands in a stranded conductor, in one single stranded conductor. If you want to know the total number of strands, you have to use this expression. X here is the number of layers. Suppose if it is a one layer is nothing but only one conductor. If you substitute x is equal to 1, you will get number of conductors, number of strands will be 1, right? If it is a two layer conductor, so two layer conductor, how many conductors will be there? 2 square, 3 into 2 square, so 12 you will get, minus 3 to the 6, so 6, 12 minus 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So second layer will be having 7 conductors, so like this, okay, like this. By using this expression, you can determine the total number of strands in a stranded conductor, right? And the overall diameter of this conductor also you can determine by using the second expression, which is d is equal to 2x minus 1 into small d. So small d here is nothing but diameter of each strand, okay? So each single strand diameter, if you know, which is d, so then you can determine the overall diameter, total overall diameter of the stranded conductor is 2x minus 1 into d. Here x is again a number of layers, okay? So like this, you can determine the number of strands and diameter of the stranded conductor. So you have to remember these two expressions. So this is, these formulas are very important for gate. So generally they will ask 1 mark for gate, 1 mark like this question, right? So now let us determine the flux linkages of one conductor in a group of conductors, okay? So now let us, here you consider n parallel conductors which are carrying currents I1, I2, I3 and so on, IN. Okay, here you are having N conductors. You have to consider N conductors. So then out of all these N conductors, you take one single conductor. So then you have to determine the flux linkages with respect to that single conductor. Okay, so this is the flux linkages of one conductor in a group of conductors. Okay, now here to determine the flux linkages, you have to assume one point P from a remote location, right? So let us see, P will be the remote point, okay? So which is at a distance d1, d2, da and dn from all these conductors, okay? So you are having a group of conductors, okay? So we want to determine the flux linkages of one conductor in this group, right? So now for determining the flux linkages, you have to assume some external point P. Okay, let us assume there is a point P from a remote location, right? Now this point P is having a distance of d1 from first conductor. Okay, when you take this first conductor, so the distance from first conductor to point P is d1, and the distance from second conductor to point P is d2. So like this, for nth conductor you are having dn, and for I and j conductors are there. So the for ith conductor, the distance is represented here, which is di, and for jth conductor, the distance is represented with dj from point P. And between two conductors here, so this distance is dij. So between two conductors I and j, distance is dij. So if you want to calculate the distance between these two, 1 and j, so this will be represented as d1j or dj1. So like this, you have to assume that distances, right? So then after assuming all these points, so the flux linkages of ith conductor, so you have to take one conductor, so the flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing through that conductor only, if you take, so then what are the flux linkages? So that expression is lambda ii. So lambda ii is nothing but flux linkages of particular conductor due to current flowing through the same conductor alone. Okay, this value is from the previous expression, this is 2 into 10 power minus 7 I here is current flowing through that particular conductor I ln di. Okay, so di is distance from remote distance of I the conductor from point P. Okay, this distance you have to consider di. So by R1 dash. Okay, so this formula is the same as the previous one. Okay, so this formula flux linkages, we are using the same formula here, 2 into 10 power minus 7 I into ln d by r. D here is nothing but distance between distance from a point, remote point Q to center of the conductor. This is distance, and r dash is the radius of the conductor. So from this expression itself we are writing directly the equation. Okay, so flux linkages of I the conductor by taking its own current is lambda ii, which is 2 into 10 power minus 7 ii ln di by r I dash, so which is in Weber per meters, right? So now next you have to write the flux linkages of the ith conductor, the same conductor, due to current flowing through the conductor j. Okay, so in the previous case this is the flux linkages of the ith conductor due to its own current, right? So now if you take the jth conductor, so the flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing through jth conductor, so then the expression for this is lambda ij here. So first suffix I is represented the ith conductor flux linkages. So j here is with respect to current flowing in the jth conductor, so which is equal to from the same expression only, 2 into 10 power minus 7. Now here what you have to assume, current is current flowing through the jth conductor, which is ij. Okay, ij ln distance from jth conductor to point P. So here distance from jth conductor to point P dj. Okay, dj. Then here in place of r dash you have to write the distance between the two conductors I and j, which is dij. Okay, right? So suppose if you want to calculate, next to like this you have to calculate the some expressions. So this is the current flux linkage of ith conductor due to current flowing through jth conductor. Suppose if you want to calculate the flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing through first conductor, suppose if you want to calculate flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing in the first conductor, so then in such a case in place of j you have to substitute simply 1, so which is nothing but lambda I1 is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 and current flowing through the first conductor I1 ln d1 you have to take here. Why? Because from the first conductor, right? D1 by distance between ith conductor and first conductor, which is di1 or d1in, both are same. Okay, so like that you can determine the flux linkages of ith conductor with respect to all other conductors. Okay, so you simply from the in this expression you have to substitute, so j is equal to 1 2 3 up to n except I. Okay, so for if you consider only I, current flowing through the conductor alone, so then the previous expression you have to take. Okay, so after getting all the expression you have to calculate the total flux linkages. Okay, total by repeated use of the above expression you have to determine the flux linkages of ith conductor with respect to all other conductors from 1 to n. So then the total flux linkages of ith conductor due to flux up to the point P, total flux linkages is lambda I is equal to lambda I1, so which is, this is the flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing through the first conductor, then plus lambda I2. Lambda I2 is nothing but flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing in the second conductor, plus and so on, plus lambda II. Lambda II is nothing but current flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing in the same conductor, so it is represented with lambda II, plus and so on, plus nth conductor, last one, so which is lambda IN, current flowing in the flux linkages of ith conductor due to current flowing in nth conductor. Okay, so here one expression we have written. So now by substituting j is equal to 1 to n, so 1 2 3 4 up to n, so you will get all flux linkages. So you have to sum the all flux linkages to get the total flux linkages with respect to one single ith conductor. Okay. So now this lambda I1 is nothing but 2 into 10 power minus 7 I1 ln D1 by D I1. Okay, 2 into 10 power minus 7, minus 7 is common for all flux linkages. So you take it common. So then I1 into ln D1 by D I1 you will get for this. Right, when you take the second one, lambda I2, so this value is 2 into 10 power minus 7. In place of J, you have to take 2. So that means I2 ln distance of second conductor to point B is D2, D2 by, so distance between I and 2, which is DI2, plus like this up to third conductor, fourth conductor, like this up to Andusan, plus same conductor you have to take here, right? So then if you take same conductor I, this is current is II ln DI by R1 dash, okay? So like sometimes you can also represent like this D11, okay? Self distance, so which is nothing but RI dash, okay? RI dash which is equal to 0.7788 R, plus on to some, if you take the nth conductor, so this will be 2 into 10 power minus 7 IN ln DN by DIN you will get, okay? So this is the final expression for flux linkages of ith conductor, only one single conductor only, so in a group of conductors, okay? So now this expression, so this expression you can write in like this, I1 ln D1 by D I1 is there, so this can be log A by log A into log B, so log AB, log AB you can write as log A plus log B, you can write, you know that formula. So now here also this expression can be written as ln 1 by DI1 into log ln D1 you can write, okay? So from this, so you can write I1 into ln D1, I1 into ln D1 plus I1 into ln 1 by DI1 you can write. So similarly for the second one, I2, I2 ln 1 by DI2 plus I2 ln D2, like this for all expression you have to write, okay? I1 into ln 1 by DI1 plus 1 I2 ln 1 by DI2, like this up to IN ln 1 by DIN, plus you will get this I1 ln D1 plus I2 ln D2 plus and sum up to IN ln DN you will get, okay? So but here in this conductor, so the current flowing through all the conductors, if you take sum will be taken as 0 here, right? Here you are considered the n number of conductors, right? So which is carrying some currents I1, I2, I3 up to IN, right? So now if you sum all these currents flowing through all the conductor, I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus up to and sum IN, right? I1 to IN, if you take sum of currents, then that will be equal to 0. You have to assume this also, right? Sum of all the currents will be equal to 0. Any doubt? Okay. Is there any doubt, ma? You mute your mic.
Sir, you can continue. Sir, you can continue.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. So here, current flowing through all the conductor, if you take sum I1 plus I2 plus up to IN, understand, up to IN, so this value, total value is equal to 0, okay? So now from this expression, only IN, if you take only IN, so this will be equal to minus of I1 plus I2 plus up to IN minus 1 you will get, okay? So now this expression you have to substitute here, okay? In place of IN you have to substitute minus I1 plus I2 plus up to and so on IN minus 1 you have to substitute in this last term. In place of IN you have to substitute this, okay? So now if you substitute this value, so then what you will get, okay? I1 ln D1 minus I1 ln DN you will get, okay? I1 ln D1 from here, so now if you take minus I1 into this value, So minus I1 ln dn you will get, right? So then I1 if you take common from the first this value, so then what you will get, ln d1 by dn you will get. Okay, here it is I1 into ln d1, next term is minus I1 into ln dn, right? Log a minus log b is nothing but log a by b. So log d1 by dn will get for I1. So now in the similar way, if you take I2 is common, so in this expression you will get I2 ln d2 by d1. So like this up to n you will have to calculate. Okay, so then if you write a final expression, so that expression will be, so 2 into 10 power minus 7, so 2 into 10 power minus 7 into all the first terms, I1 ln 1 by di1 plus I2 ln 1 by di2 plus and so on, ii ln 1 by dr1 ri dash plus and so on plus in ln 1 by din plus here, so for the second expression, in place of in, if you substitute minus I1 plus I2 plus and so on in minus 1, so then after some simplification, you will get this term. Okay, the second term, second plus after plus, okay, which is I1 plus ln d1 by dn plus I2 ln d2 by dn up to I n minus 1 ln d n minus 1 by dn. Okay, so now here you have to take another assumption that your point P is taken to infinity. Okay, so here this point P, suppose if this point P is at infinity distance, so it is so much distance, so then if you take the distance from ith conductor to that point P, which is at infinity, and jth conductor to that infinity point, distance will be almost same. Okay, so dyi and dj, so both values will be almost equal when your point P is at infinity. Okay, so that means d1 to P, d2 to P, d3 to P, dn to P, from all the conductors to a point P which is at infinity will have the same distances, or approximately equal, you can say. So in such a case, so this d1 and dn both are same, so they will get cancelled, and ln 1 you will get. So similarly d2 dn are the same, so if you cancel these two, you will get again ln 1. So in all these terms, ln 1 you will get. So you know that log of 1 is nothing but 0. Okay, so thus entire this expression, second one, okay, this will become 0, right? So this total expression will become equal to 0 when you consider your point P is at infinity. Okay, so then the total flux linkages of one single conductor, which is I, so in a group of conductor, is the final expression is this one. Okay, only the first term only you will get. So 2 into 10 power minus 7 I1 ln 1 by di1 plus I2 ln 1 by di2 plus and so on plus ii ln 1 by dii. So dii is nothing but, you can write here self distance, which is ri dash. Okay, plus and so on in ln 1 by din, so which is Weber turns per meter. Flux linkages are here, are you have to represent units as Weber turns per meter. Okay, so is there any doubt up to this point mark? So depending upon these equations only, you can finally derive the equations for other things. So if you are not understood these points, so you just raise your questions. Okay, unless you understand this, you cannot understand other things. Okay, if you are having any doubts, you ask me. Okay, so the, which is nothing but this this one is this one, the first equation, we can say it as a generalized equation. Okay, which is nothing but current flowing in the one conductor in a group of conductors. Suppose if there is a group of conductors, and if you want to calculate the flux linkages with respect to only one conductor, so then this is the first equation is the generalized equation. So the same equation I am repeating in the this slide. So which is generalized equation to determine the flux linkages in a group of conductor is lambda I is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 I1 ln 1 by di1 plus I2 ln 1 by di2 plus and so on up to in ln 1 by din. So Weber turns per meter. So this is the generalized expression. Okay. So now this equation, this expression can be used for determining the flux linkages of any system. It is a two conductor system or three conductor system or any number of conductors are there. So you can determine the flux linkages of one conductor with respect to all other conductors. Okay. So simply I am taking a single phase system, so which is having two conductors. Okay. So then I want to calculate the flux linkages. Okay. So if you know the flux linkages, you can also determine the inductance also. Okay. So let us assume there is a two conductors in a single phase system, so which are represented with 1 and 2. Okay. And the distance between these two, let it be d 1 2. Let us assume the distance between two conductors in a single phase system is d 1 2, right? And the radius of each conductor is, this one will be r 1, this one will be r 2. Okay. Now, so from this generalized expression, okay, so you have to write the flux linkage equations. Okay. Suppose here you have written ith conductor flux linkages. So now I want to calculate the flux linkages of first conductor in a two conductor system. So lambda 1 is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 I 1 ln 1 by 1 1. Okay. In place of I, simply you have to substitute 1 and you have to proceed only up to two conductors, that means only up to I 2 you have to proceed. Okay, up to this only, right? So I 1 ln 1 by d 1 1 plus I 2 ln 1 by d 1 2. So that's all. So these are the flux linkages of first conductor in a two conductor system. So if you want to calculate the flux linkages of second conductor, okay, so when you take the second conductor from the same expression, 2 into 10 power minus 7 I 1 ln 1 by, so distance between second conductor to first conductor here you have to take. Okay. So d 1 2 plus I 2 ln 1 by d 2 2. Okay. So like this you can extend to the other system also. So if you take three conductor system, so here you are having three conductors A, B, C here, and the distance between A, B is d 1 2 and the distance between A, C is d 3 1 and distance between B, C is d 2 3. Right. So from this above equation, generalized equation, so you determine the flux linkages of one conductor with in a group of conductor, which is here group is nothing but only three. Okay. So now flux linkages of eighth conductor, if you write, then 2 into 10 power minus 7 first IA, IA is the self one. Okay. So now here in the above equation also d 1 1 is nothing but r 1 dash you have to write, d 2 2 is nothing but r 2 dash. Okay. Here also d i a is nothing but r I dash, you have to remember this. Okay. Self distances you can say. Okay. Right. For a three conductor system, if you write the flux linkages for the first conductor A, so this will be 2 into 10 power minus 7 into current flowing to the first conductor I a ln 1 by self distance. Okay. I a ln 1 by d a a you have to write. Self distance d a a is nothing but r a dash, eighth conductor radius. Here while calculating inductance, if you consider internal flux as well as external flux, that r will become r dash, which is 0.7788 r. okay. So then plus flux linkages due to the current flowing in the bth conductor, which is current flowing through the bth conductor is ib, into ln 1 by, so distance from A to B you have to write here, which is d 1 2. So then current flow flux linkages of eighth conductor due to current flowing through the cth conductor is IC ln 1 by distance between third conductor and C conductor and A conductor, which is d 3 1. So this is the total flux linkages with respect to conductor A. Similarly, for total flux linkages with respect to conductor B is 2 into 10 power minus 7. So now I am writing, you can write the first as self current, which is IB into ln 1 by D, so DBB here, right? When we are writing for the bth conductor, it is So dBb. Okay. So plus when you take the current flowing through the first conductor IA, so this will be IA ln 1 by distance from A to B you have to take, which is D12. So this is D12. Sorry, here some errors came. So this is D12 you have to take, plus flux due to current flowing in the Cth conductor, which will be IC into ln 1 by B to C, distance is 2-3. So this is 2-3. Okay. Similarly, you can extend the same thing to Cth conductor also. Okay. So when conductor Cth, when C, when you take C as IC into ln CC, you have to get. So CC is nothing but RC dash. Okay. Here you have to get RC dash. Now when you take B, so C to B distance is 2-3. So this will be 2-3. And when you take first conductor A, so IA into ln A to B distance is D12. So in place of here you have to write D12. Okay. So like this, you can determine the flux linkages of one conductor with respect to other conductors in your group. Okay. Right. Okay. I think it is 4. So shall we stop here, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now in the tomorrow's class, we will determine the inductance of the composite conductor. Okay, if you are having any doubts, ma'am, you ask me.